We're back. Thank you for tuning in.
Absolutely.
Stick around in this video. What do we do in this video? We talk about, wait till you hear what his favorite book of all time was.
Absolutely.
It's
a banger.
Check out the Rushmore of favorite toys.
Toys of the 90s.
And we are officially running for president.
Yep. It's an election year, baby.
Stick around.
Is this on?
The Outta Nowhere podcast was filmed in front of a live studio audience.
What's up, everybody? How's everybody doing today?
We're back from Outta Nowhere.
How you doing, buddy?
Well, listen, we are going to be doing something crazy today.
Uncharted.
We're not going to waste your time. We're not going to waste your time with hellos, goodbyes. What we're going to do is we usually pick four topics, but not today.
Not today.
Who's going to pick the four topics today?
Not our listeners, I can tell you that right now.
Yeah. Well, actually, we did get some feedback. We did get some listener feedback. They chose some topics
poorly.
Yeah,
actually.
But
we're gonna go with we're gonna rely, just like the rest of the world now is a big push into AI. And not Allen Iverson, believe it or not. I think I did that joke again. But that's right.
Yeah.
I don't know anybody else with the initials AI.
Well, we'll have to do some research.
All right. But what I'm going to do is,
you know who you can ask?
I'm actually going to hit this button on my phone and generate. See, we already decided to do maybe four topics here.
We have those four topics.
But I'm going to hit generate now.
Let's hit generate. Don't even tell me what they are. Let's just take them one at a time.
Look, that's what's coming up. These are our four.
And we're going to try to do it all within a normal...
Can you see that?
What, you want them to see it first?
Take
it back a little bit.
This is proof.
Bring it back.
Bring it back.
We just generated that right now.
Okay. So
I'm going to put 5 minutes on the clock. Don't look at them. I mean, you can. You got to look at the first one at least.
Well,
because we may have to do some on-the-spot research.
Yes. Right? So this is what we're going to do it like that.
5 minutes on the clock.
All right. Current event and policy
and politics.
Wow. In an election year.
Yeah.
All right.
So, yeah, we have the election coming up. We have Mr. Donald Trump.
Who are you going to vote for?
Tell me everything you know about politics, religion, and how much you make. How much you make.
And the last four of your social.
Yeah.
Well,
your PIN number.
I mean, current events, I mean, this is my take on politics.
Okay.
It is so funny how these characters,
yeah,
are the best we have as a nation.
I was going to say the same thing.
All right?
It's
so sad how much money and agenda is put against the other party.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
So, I mean, yes, it's funny now as our president's term is coming to a screeching halt.
But how, they're so
I'm just
old.
Saying, that's my whole point.
How
is that, how can this person effectively lead a nation?
Not only that,
we don't have anybody else. These two ancient people.
Yeah. They're both, is Biden in his 80s? 70s,
hundreds,
top 80s,
100s,
800s,
80s, 90s, and today.
I mean,
this is PLJ here.
Yeah, but I mean, it is an election year right now. I think I just saw something today that the Supreme Court ruled that the state ballots cannot remove Trump's name.
Okay.
So, if you wanted to vote for Trump, now's your chance because. You have till November.
I don't know.
Think about it.
I really don't know enough on this. I literally don't watch, even though we have to vote in November.
Yeah.
And at the time of this video, it's very, very early on, and they're still doing caucuses.
I just think there's a lot of lying. There's a lot of stuff that you can't follow up with.
A lot of Eddie Guerrero.
A little lie, cheat, and steal.
I'm your poppy.
I'm your poppy now. But,
Does
that make sense?
I think so.
You can't. I don't know. There should be a way to go back.
Yeah.
Like, let's say in 4 months after you're elected.
Right.
What have you done that you said you were going to do?
Like keeping the receipt. Keep the receipt.
Yeah. Keep the receipt for 2 years.
Oh, two years.
Well,
they impeach people.
All they do, they come in and they remove everything that was done the previous 4 years.
Right. And then, that takes a year.
Exactly.
And then what?
then it looks like you haven't done anything that year.
Right.
Because all you've done is reverse what happened.
Because you're bad-mouthing the previous regime.
Right.
And you're like, oh, they messed it all up. They did this. They messed up our awesome economy.
Yeah.
Now we have to derail it so we could build our economy.
So the I remember one of the... this is one of the reasons that I voted for who I voted for.
Okay. Well done. Actually, you almost tripped up there.
Well, no, I can't tell you the story. Now I can't tell you the story of what he did. But I'll change the story now. I remember when he first got elected, all he wanted to do was keep jobs in America.
Yes.
And I remember the first week he was in, I think it was Ford. Someone was planning on moving their plant to Mexico. And he stopped them from doing it.
Yes.
And they built the plant wherever.
Uh-huh.
And then what happened? What happened? But again, to your point, I don't know enough, and I think the problem with voting in general is nobody knows enough.
It's skewed. It's so skewed. I mean, and honestly, as Americans, we're Americans here, okay? Yeah. And these colors don't run.
Yeah.
All right.
Well,
that's a Cummins
pretty much
diesel.
America.
That's a Cummins diesel right there. I don't know.
Yeah,
if
but
you know.
It's the Stars and Stripes.
I know.
I don't know if you knew that.
Absolutely. Thanks for noticing.
Mm-hmm.
The one thing that we don't. I think we share the common folk here that this will be viewed by is that we're in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
All the things that you see in the news is the extremes. Okay? Billy Joel said, I think
he doesn't know why
we go to extremes.
Yeah.
Okay? You see like the 5% on each side burning down cities, storming the Capitol. Okay? Like all these things are the lunatics at the ends of the spectrum.
Yeah.
We are on the spectrum.
I think
we're within the spectrum, if you know what I mean.
But I think I don't really see it affecting me one way or another.
Well, it's like
financially.
Yeah.
Don't see anything. I don't really see it affecting me.
You will. You do.
How?
You do.
Listen, inflation. Listen. COVID did whatever it did, and things are still trying to get back to level with that.
Well,
was it anybody's fault? You can sit there and you can blame one person. You can sit there and blame the other person.
It's that Fauci guy.
And where is he now? How much did he make?
Not even.
It all comes down to money.
Not even a practicing doctor in the last like decade.
Here's our
authority.
Yeah.
I'm taking a stand.
Yes, I think this is what it all comes down to.
Right.
It comes down to my taxpayer money goes to.
Right.
Right.
Exactly.
So for all these all the migrants that are coming in, I don't know if you've seen these videos of people flooding
America.
You got the Chinese people coming in now too.
Yep.
Chinese from up top, up north, some Mexicans.
You know what's interesting?
That's five.
You just touched on it and you literally I don't even think you realize what you just said.
Mm.
Okay? Now,
oh, I do.
Don't get me wrong. I am a patron of Chinese food. Okay? However, did you know? And actually, I may even throw it to a clip. I don't know.
Clip it.
Of Joe Rogan.
Yeah.
Okay?
What's happening with Chinese buying, the Chinese government or Chinese nationals buying farmland? And I've got a map, if I can find it, of where they're buying this land, and it's around U.S. military installations. They're buying up land around U.S. military installations. And so when you look at the amount of land that they're buying, it's not all that much. I mean, it's a lot of land, but given as much land as there is, it's like maybe less than 1%. But when you look at it strategically around military installations, it's really concerning. And then when you look at what's happening at those military installations that they have land around, like B-2 stealth bomber training, drone training and all, it's very, very troubling.
God, it's so strategic where it's all placed.
Yeah, if I can get a hold of that map and show it to you.
It's kind of crazy that the United States has been invaded.
A He's
a former podcaster. A fellow podcaster. He's learned a lot from us.
He actually showed in one of his recent podcasts of how much, like, in the surrounding, like, major cities mm-hmm. of America, mm-hmm. how much land, mm-hmm. how much resources, mm-hmm. how much the Chinese have purchased and have acquired over the last 3 years.
Yeah.
And there's a whole big conspiracy that's out there of how do you take down the U.S. And it was published like 10, 15 years ago.
Let me guess. Go to the surrounding major cities and buy up a whole bunch of land.
Dude, they're running a playbook right now. Yeah. And it's literally like, and who was going to do it?
Mm-hmm.
And who had the most resources in order to do it?
Yeah.
By the way, I have to check to see how my wish order is going.
But also, let's also keep in mind too, we're paying.
Oh.
We're footing the bill because they're not coming here legally. Some of them are coming legally.
Yes.
The ones that are coming here doing that. But yes. I'm talking about the ones that are coming illegally.
Oh, right.
Are coming in.
Yep.
Not only are we paying the taxes for them because they're not paying for
correct.
It. They use our schools.
Correct.
They use our hospitals. They correct. Use our roads.
Our resources, right.
They use the resources that we pay for with tax dollars.
Yep.
Then you get places like New York
yep.
who are spending millions of dollars
yep. of taxpayer money.
Keep them in shelters and it's just
right. It's crazy.
We need to move on. ChatGPT has already pissed me off.
Wow. ChatGPT, you don't know.
ChatGPT.
Okay, here we go. Topic number two.
Let's get to five and begin.
All right. Strategies for career advancement and professional development.
I don't think you put like something funny on here. These are random topics.
These are literally random. But you know what?
I think we're going to put our own spin on this.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
It's us.
Lie, cheat, and steal.
So
go back to the beginning.
We're all going
to. Lie, cheat, and steal.
We're both going to be. Opposing politicians. Mm-hmm. And that's what we're going to do for the remainder of this year. And at the end of this year, in November, our Election Day special, we will actually ask everybody to cast their vote, Team Matt or Team John.
Oh, okay.
I think that's what we're going to do.
That is a great idea.
Thank you. So that's what we're going to do. The strategies for career, our political career.
So why don't we use this 5 minutes right now?
So
I'll yield the floor for you. This is your platform.
All right. So as your president of the Outta Nowhere podcast, I vow to bring cutting edge content, amazing editing, and try to shut this guy up as quick as I can. That's all I got to do. And I'm out.
I'll be like the other candidates while you're talking. I'll just roll my eyes and be like,
hold on. Let me go. Let me do what all the other candidates, all the other candidates do when you talk, or all the other voters do.
Talking about real voters.
I'm surprised that you're not interrupting me right now.
I'm talking about real voters. that's what you're gonna go with?
No.
So you're gonna all right. So let's make this a thing.
Let's make this a thing.
Let's go think. John for president or Matt for president
of our podcast.
Of our podcast.
Right.
Yes.
Yes.
And what happens as president?
You're at whatever you want.
All right. as
last
your president,
time I checked, this was a dictatorship.
Listen. See, he's already interrupting me. That's what he does, people. You try to get a point across and he interrupts constantly.
He's not even Italian. Look at him.
You know,
JP, comment on that.
You don't know that.
I know for sure. You're.
What I will do as your president, I will make sure that you will have cutting edge audio that's on. Is this on?
Is
you're asking?
This on?
And I will make sure that our topics, I will make sure that we never have to rely on ChatGPT again. And if we do, it will have a little bit more. It'll have a little bit more behind it than what it gave us.
Hold on, I gotta.
I will say.
Write down rebuttals.
Write down your rebuttals. Listen, I am not. I do not want to take taxpayer money. Every dollar that we make on this podcast, I've already put it in. Put it back into the podcast.
Ah.
We went through the budget. I slashed last year's budget, and we are moving on with better topics. I know what you people want. It's content, topics, and you want to have a good time.
Mm.
All this guy wants, I don't even know what he wants. He wants to go to sleep. Are you for? If you want to vote for someone who's not for, vote for Matt of this podcast.
All right, so, and I have a chance to actually rebut what you just said.
I don't think so.
I have a question for you, actually.
I'd let you go first.
I have one question.
That's like taking the kick.
No,
you don't get to do it again.
I have 1 minute of response to that.
I control the clock.
I have one question for you.
Your minute's canceled, yeah.
Who's Rohan?
I have a rebuttal to that. Are you better off now than you were with him?
Well, I had the same ideas as somebody, and you know what? You don't mess with the Rohan.
No, what the same ideas? What are you talking about?
I had the exact same. See, this is gonna divide and conquer. I hope he watches this.
Yeah, he's not watching. He already did it for us.
Oh, this is gonna be funny. I think at the beginning of every video, I think we just have the. Dun, dun,
dun, dun, yeah. dun, 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 well, it's gonna have to be now.
And then we're gonna until
November.
We'll get one topic.
We'll get one topic each every.
Oh my gosh, ChatGPT, you've ruined our podcast.
No, I think I would disagree, but I think
that was awesome.
I think going forward, every one of every topic of the four that we discussed should be a debate.
It needs
to
be.
Yeah, and like ketchup versus mustard.
Well, there's that way
viewers will get a better understanding of where our values are.
Well, right, and then you the voter subscriber,
I love it.
Can choose the right answer.
We're gonna have to somehow get our ballot out there on every in every township.
Well, check out our Instagram page because you could definitely do that on there. Vote for the content on there.
Can we vote?
Well, yeah, we can create a poll. Yeah, we can put a poll up there because we can also put a poll on YouTube. But I think Instagram is going to be a better one.
I think we do that. Listen, I think even though we're recording this now, I think when we're done with this, we put up an initial poll.
Yeah.
Now.
Oh yeah.
We'll see how
we're trending.
How we're trending. Yeah.
We'll have a graph. All three votes will be calculated.
No, seriously though, if you really want to, grow your career. Just be good at your job and backstab and just climb that corporate ladder.
Well, that's going to show your values right there.
That's five.
I will appease my fellow candidate. All right, number three, we're going here. Oh, I don't even know this one. I can't even read it. I can't even read it. Give me five on the clock.
I'm starting five on the clock, but we'll be done in like 30 seconds.
Do you have any book recommendations?
I'll tell you. The last book I read, and if you can find a picture of it, that'd be great. It was like a behind the scenes of Saved by the Bell.
A book.
I think Screech came out. I remember Screech. I think Screech came out
as an MMA fighter. Mm-mm. He was.
No, I know he was. And I think he got killed by Horshack. Or no, I think it was the other way around. I think he killed Horshack.
Well, Screech did die. Period.
Oh.
R.I.P.
No, the last book I read.
Yeah, what was the last book?
I swear to God, was
whatever that was the name of it?
Whatever the
swear to God,
swear to God, hand to God was. It was I don't know the name of it. It was a name for. It was like behind the scenes. Mm-hmm. I believe it was written by Screech.
Yeah,
Samuel Powers.
Samuel L. Powers.
Dustin Diamond.
The Diamond Cutter.
Yeah.
Literature.
Book recommendations and discussions about literature. Did you read that already?
Yeah.
That's what this topic
is. The second part because I was peeing my pants laughing about the discussion about literature.
Well, we can go back.
Well, let me tell you this. That's
the best I got.
Okay, so I'm a religious guy, I like to think. I have read the Bible. I can recommend that.
You read the whole thing?
Yeah.
The whole thing?
The whole
cover
thing.
Cover to cover.
Cover to cover, baby.
John 3:14.
3:14.
What is that?
I can't quote it. Now you're asking me to recall it.
Okay.
I know what Genesis 3:16 says.
Do you know how it ends?
Spoiler alert.
It's like the dictionary.
Like the dictionary?
Well, I read the dictionary. It turns out the zebra did it.
Actually, I would have said, no, never mind. I was going to say xylophone, but I can't spell, apparently.
No.
No. So the book recommendation, I won't give a recommendation because minus the Bible, I have never read a book. I can pride myself on that.
Yeah.
Cover to cover, I have never read a book.
No. And I can't even start and finish a video game.
I mean, and it's funny because I've been in studies and stuff like that and like, you know, teams and things like that.
I'm trying to think.
But they've only said read these three quarters of the book because the other stuff they've omitted. And it's like, wait a minute, what? But... even in school, how'd you get through school?
How are you a college graduate? Simple.
Lie, cheat, and steal. No. give me an Eddie.
We have a running
theme.
A running theme this morning.
No, but I mean, like, there's so many, and this was The infancy of the internet.
I think
so. There's no ChatGPT to help me out make a report. I mean, I never Cliff
even,
Notes,
never even
Monarch
read
Notes,
never even
Monarch
read
Notes were the key. I mean, and then when Barnes and Noble came in, first Barnes and Noble came in to Ledgewood. That was key because I need you to take me down there and get me the Cliff Notes, Monarch Notes. What do you mean? You don't want to buy the book? Nope, don't need the book. No. Just need this, and it was great. So anyway, but that's my 2 cents.
Get how the about Monarch Notes. How about since we're out of nowhere-ing this with ChatGPT?
Yeah.
Movies based on books.
Oh, well,
see,
movies based on books.
Yeah,
go ahead.
Almost all of them are
right,
like a Harry Potter,
The Notebook.
The Notebook, that's a great movie. If you just want to sit in, if you have, you know, if it's a rainy day and you just want to sit on the couch,
yeah,
with your boo. I think a lot of Disney movies started out as books too.
Right.
And they were just ripped off. Disney, seriously.
The Ice Princess?
Yeah, no, Disney ripped them off.
Yeah.
I'm not mad at it.
I ain't mad at you.
I ain't mad at you. But anyway,
but no, I mean, are there any books that are out there that you would want to read?
No.
Do you have time to read any books?
No.
You really don't.
No.
Have you ever done books? Actually, so does book on tape or CD?
Either matter? Way, it doesn't matter.
So actually, the...
Audible.
Yeah, Audible. Because I have read a book. I've listened to a book. Okay. There it is.
Yeah.
What was the one with Tom Hanks and the... oh my gosh. It was a movie. And it had to do with... you were talking about movies based on books. It was so good, I can't remember the
Captain
title.
Phillips?
Nope. It was like...
Turner and Hooch.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, Turner and Hooch. Audible.
Bosom Buddies.
I want...
Well, didn't
I want
you read,
an Audible
no, the, Turner honestly, and Hooch. The last thing you and I read together as a couple was the script.
from My Cousin Vinny. My Cousin Vinny's script, the actual script.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, that's so funny.
No, I cannot give out a book recommendation.
What? The Da Vinci Code. Oh my gosh, Da Vinci Code.
That's based on a book, yeah.
Well, no, I listened to the book, and it was funny because...
But why?
That wasn't funny book, but you listened to it, and it was slightly different. Than the movie.
Well, they always say, "Oh, the book is way
the book is way more descriptive."
Well, you know what I like about the movie? No reading.
Oh, this is a great thing. Yeah. What about foreign films?
Mm.
And then where you have to read the subtitles?
Mm-mm.
And I'm not talking about like the Italian Job.
Mm-mm.
Okay.
No.
Yeah, no. I'm not a fan of reading. I don't like to read my movies.
No.
Okay.
No.
I also don't like to read my books. I want to listen to my books.
Yep. I want the books read to me.
Read to me. And that's great.
I'll tell you this one.
Morgan Freeman.
I believe I was in. I believe I was in fifth grade. I had to do a book report.
Okay.
And I did not finish the book. And I remember it was after recess. We came in after recess, and I was specifically like, I think it may have been hot, but I was like, I knew I had to read this book report, and I did not have it done because I didn't read the end of it. So, I know this is going to sound stupid, and I can't believe I even got away with it, but I was pretending like I had a headache, and I was about to pass out.
Yes.
And I'm reading the book report. I'm reading the book report out loud to the class, and I literally, at the end, I said, to learn more about this book. Make sure you check out whatever the name of the book was, because I did not have it done. I did not have it finished.
That's how you ended the presentation?
Yes. And I did not get a good grade on
what'd
that.
What'd you get on it?
I don't remember.
A C?
I couldn't read. It could have been a C, could have been an A. I have no idea.
If you didn't fail
that's it. That's 5, by the way.
If you didn't fail it, I mean...
Yeah, I'm sure I did.
Well, that's amazing. I mean, you did three quarters of the work.
Look at me now.
Well, that brings us to the last topic, believe it or not. All right.
This is going
to
be a show.
Well, this is great coming from us, by the way.
Yeah.
Health and wellness tips for managing stress and staying active.
Let's start the fiber.
Step one.
Do a podcast.
Step one. Delete ChatGPT from your phone.
No.
I'm just kidding.
Do you see why? You see why this is here?
Yeah.
That's all you typed in.
I know. Calm down.
No, but I'm just telling you.
But you know what? I think this is the fast. Fastest 20 minutes.
This is turning into a self-help book.
Well,
on video,
we might actually write down every word that we're saying.
Well,
and
Gemini, Google Gemini. Did you figure that out yet?
No.
Listen. We'll use this to our advantage. We'll use this to our advantage. I'm very rarely stressed. I should be, but I'm not.
As you can see from Exhibit A, I let my hair grown out.
So stressed. He's so stressed.
It just literally falls out.
That happens, yeah.
Anyway.
So, be water.
Water.
That's how you can, relieve stress.
Yeah.
But I'd go to the gym.
You go to the gym?
Yeah.
I know.
That's great.
I belong to a gym.
Well, yeah, I know, but you...
I know a guy
named
Jim.
You can't just hang out at the gym and look through the window at the people that are working out.
But they don't allow Big Macs in there.
They will. Yeah, it's funny, the Planet Fitness...
On Fridays?
Well, not only that, they have pizza.
And they have bagels.
And, yes, they have bagel, I think, on Tuesdays, right?
I think so.
I think it's on Tuesdays. They serve bagels at Planet Fitness. You know, it's $10 a month.
It's practically free.
So you're getting... Well, you're getting four bagels and pizza.
That's amazing.
That would be a topic. If I was homeless, because I can give you. I know how we could. Yeah.
How to be homeless in 2024?
How to be homeless in 2024?
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Stay tuned, because that's going to be great. That's going to be a great one. I think
managing stress and staying active.
I really so we have not together, but we have kids, and I think those. Alone, those kids, whether it's, you know, running around and I collapse.
Grabbing at things?
Oh my gosh.
That they shouldn't be touching?
Your kid is so much younger, but I have a 6-year-old is my youngest, and it's like just running around. I mean, now it's more of a taxi service, but at the end of the day, just literally the running around.
Exhausted.
And just going 5 times to Walmart in a given day, 3 times to Home Depot, and twice to ShopRite in a day.
Wow.
A day, all right?
In one a day.
One a day. It's just a pain because when am I going to just sit down and watch our podcast?
I don't know.
I don't know.
I find time.
No, you just listen to us.
No, but you played a couple times with us, but we used to, younger years.
Yeah.
Well, this is probably going
not
back.
The Wonder Years?
This is probably going
younger,
10 years.
The younger years. Yeah,
this is about 10 years.
Oh, yeah. It was right when I moved.
We should still be playing, but we played football Thursday.
Flag football.
At night.
Yep. In the summer.
Yep. No, well, here's the funny thing, because it started as two-hand touch, and we played two-hand touch. Never, ever an injury. The very first day we play with flags. So here's the problem with the flags too. It's got a socket and it fits into the socket. Yep. These are brand
with the lotion.
New.
Oh yes.
Brand new. So they were really, really stuck in there. And you really had to pull and twist to get those things out. They didn't come out easily.
That's right.
Yeah. So one play. It's a pass. I go to grab the flag, which I didn't want.
I
was against the flags.
Yep.
You were there?
No. I heard about this. I started playing literally 2 weeks after this.
No, you were there. No, because we played. That was the last I ever played.
And no.
Yes, it was.
No way.
Yes, it was.
No.
Yes, we played before. You were there. Trust me. Anyway, I get my finger caught basically in a fat fold.
Whoa.
Of this guy.
Not me.
No, not this guy, because he claims he wasn't there. But I went to go pull the flag out, and in return snapped my finger.
In the glove.
In the glove.
You guys had receiving gloves.
Yes, we had gloves on, yeah.
I wasn't there that week.
So, yeah, I remember walking off, and JP's wife.
Yeah. It goes, what?
Where are you going?
Yeah, why?
She's like, where are you going? I said, I broke my finger. She said, which one?
Tell?
I said, it's the one that looks like an S. Because it was like broken like this. And I thought I was hoping it was just dislocated, but no.
Nope.
Man. Clean break. Never did the rehab. So going back to our health and wellness.
Strong hand.
Yeah. I still can't bend it all the way.
Wow.
Like I can't make a fist. Like I'll still knock you out. Mama said knock you out. Yeah.
But you can play that C chord pretty well on a...
It's like a built-in capo.
It is.
Yeah.
Slide guitar.
Yeah.
Again, how to make money in 2024.
Yeah.
But no.
That's the fiver.
That's fiver already?
Yeah. Man,
good. I had so much C. I didn't even...
On health and
I'm not
wellness.
Health. Go to Five Guys.
Hey.
Hey.
Eating is exercise.
We actually did...
eating is exercise.
It's coming out in a couple weeks. Our review.
Seems like forever.
Not this coming Monday... Or no.
No, today.
No, I'm sorry. At the time of this video, it will be Monday. It is our Five Guys
review. This is Thursday.
At the time of this video, the next Monday video that you will see.
All right.
will be our review on Five Guys.
Right.
We actually, I think I left it in that, where it's actually healthier. It's
got a great thumbnail, too.
What? Yeah. It's actually healthier mm-hmm. for you
mm-hmm.
to eat the fries,
mm-hmm.
or no, eat the shake that we didn't review,
then the fries.
So have ice cream instead of french fries.
Why don't we do this? Why don't we take a quick break?
But before that, can I just have one closing remark?
Yeah.
It's all relative. It's all relative.
Yeah.
I mean, the politicians have our back. I mean, they
As your president, I will allow you to eat whatever you want, whenever you want. However long you want.
Exactly. You could take that to the bank. Anyway, no, I agree with Matt.
To the cardiologist.
I think we should take a break. Yeah. I definitely think, but when we come back,
yeah,
there's going to be
a Rushmore.
Not back here, because we're back at the studio, but we're going to have our own Rushmores that we're going to discuss.
Ooh, I can't wait.
Well, check out a word from our sponsors.
Yeah. Wait till you see what this Rushmore is going to be.
I can't believe it.
Dun, 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 dun. The Star Wars trilogy is back on the big screen and in selected bags of Doritos. Everyone's excited, some more than others.
Help me, Obi-Wan. You're our only hope.
Chewie, don't worry about me. You gotta rescue the princess now.
Luke, I am your father. It's true.
Now celebrate with Star Wars 3D motion cards. Collect all six in specially marked bags of Doritos tortilla chips.
Yoda, I've come to complete my training.
Oh, we are back. What'd you think of that commercial?
In some ways, it's like we never left.
Wow.
I love that commercial, personally.
It was good.
And I think it's pretty relevant for what our next Rushmore is.
Yes.
We're going to Rushmore.
We're there.
And we're going to pick our top four favorite...
All time.
Toys. Is it just toys?
Yeah.
Toys, collectibles.
Yep.
From the 1980s and 90s or...
From our youth.
From
our youth.
Last...
I think we should say, like, because there are some mm-hmm. that I wish I had.
Okay.
That my friends had, and I was totally jealous that they had them.
Sure.
But I vividly remember playing with them. I had portions of it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you had one thing, and then they had the other, and then you would go to their house, and then you play, and then it would break, and then you get mad, and then,
yeah, then, you never
then the parents got involved, yep. right? And then there's a restraining order.
Yes. Yes.
And then
yes,
you
yes,
all
yes,
had to go to... Yes. You know, ISS or OSS, out of school or in school suspension.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, it's a whole big long thing.
All because of that one toy.
We also had to get new names. I don't know about you.
But, identities.
New identities. That was before identity theft was a thing. Yeah. They actually gave you a new identity.
Yeah. Well, we're here live.
There we go.
At Rushmore.
You look so interested.
Go
in
for
this.
It. Why don't you start with the top four?
Okay. What? So you can
or
steal?
We can go one to one. Would you rather that?
Well,
so I don't steal yours?
I don't believe you that you... I mean, I see that you have a list, but I don't believe any of them...
Well, to jog my memory, I mean, I
don't believe any of these are you've had or anything like that.
Let me ask you this. Are you putting video games? Because I'd like to take
videos... No. Zero video games are on my list.
Let's take that off the table.
First one, Nintendo Entertainment Center.
My favorite.
My favorite of all time. No, actually... I will go first. I'm not looking at your stupid list.
Give me one. Give me the first one then.
Optimus Prime.
And you're going to blame me?
No, because I had the original one with the Pepsi logo on the side of the trailer.
Okay.
I still have my Optimus Prime. I don't have his hands. First to go. I have my Optimus Prime. Yeah. And if I can... I'll take a picture of it, put it up here.
Let's just go one for one. But because I was going to say Transformers.
Transformers. Optimus Prime was my...
I'm not going to say Optimus Prime. I did have Optimus Prime. But the story that I remember is at my birthday, probably 4 or 5 years old.
Yes.
Someone had given me a unwrapped... I mean, it was wrapped, but it was out of the box. Just an old Transformer.
That's awesome.
It seems like. But do you remember that it was metal?
Oh, it's die-cast metal.
It is hard. That is metal. You want to hit your little brother over the head with it?
Yeah.
You can, and it'll leave a gash.
It's metal and plastic.
Yeah.
So, I mean, half of it was plastic, but okay, now you could go.
Yeah, I'm not gonna take that one.
You're not taking
one? No, okay. I'm not going to take the one. But I do know one of the toys that I had that I absolutely loved. Was looking at my list. No, I used to have the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
All of them?
I would have all four of them, yes. And they all had They had very little, tiny, thin plastic utility belts, and I think one of them had a strap, but it was...
Donatello had the strap.
Yeah.
Go on.
No, that's it.
That's it? That's all you remember from your list?
For that one, yes. No, I thought you're going to go now.
Well, did you have Master Splinter or any Shredder?
I had Shredder, yes. Ooh, yes. Okay. And I actually remember having, because they also, at the time, had the cartoon out.
They did.
And I had...
I love that cartoon.
Krang.
So good. Krang. Yeah, Master Krang.
With the
Krang.
Little... Yeah.
With the brain?
He was the brain.
He was the brain.
Yeah, and then the little robot.
So, my second one...
Mm-hmm.
Has to go G.I. Joe. This is the one I wanted, okay? Yeah. Was the G.I. Joe aircraft carrier.
Mm-hmm.
All right? So I... Now, not the OG G.I. Joes that were literally a 12-inch
right.
one. I had the little ones.
With the scar.
What?
It had a scar. The original G.I. Joes had a scar. Go ahead.
I didn't know that. Because that was from like the 70s. And that's not in the realm of our discussion here.
Well, okay? Kind of is. It's out of nowhere.
It's out of nowhere. Out of the 70s.
It's out of nowhere.
That 70s show.
Yeah.
But no, the I guess they're 4-inch G.I. Joes that mm-hmm. were issued in the 80s. I wanted the aircraft carrier. Now, how much is that aircraft carrier worth? First of all, it's like the size of the studio. Okay.
Yes,
it's massive. And you had to put it together.
Yeah.
And I think you didn't
have to.
I think in the 80s, I want to say that thing was like $200.
Probably.
And, yeah. You know, I think my parents even said, I'm not paying $200 for a piece of plastic. Mm-hmm. I think it was.
Mm-hmm.
But they did pay, I think it was $20, $30 yeah. for that die-cast metal.
They had no problem paying for my college.
Or those Marlboro points paid for my college. Marlboro points. That's what we should do one time, is what were the most ridiculous...
Things from the catalog?
Things from the catalog. Ooh. We got to get our hands on...
We do.
A Winston points or Marlboro points.
We could get that, yeah.
All right, we get that easily. Yeah. Anyway, so that's two. The G.I. Joe aircraft carrier.
One thing that I did not have...
Yes.
BK had... Was the Ghostbusters firehouse.
The firehouse. Dude.
With Ecto-1.
Ecto-1.
Yes.
So yes.
He had that. I mean... Yeah,
dude,
but,
so good.
But that... There was so... I don't even think they make anything like that anymore.
No.
Where it's like the full... That is another big, gigantic piece of plastic.
Yes. That's all it was.
And I believe it had a fire pole.
Yep.
And... I can't think of anything else, but I know that it had that. We had Slimer. I didn't even have it. I didn't have any of those things.
Uh-huh. It's too messy. Too messy, I think.
Yeah.
So if you're done, I want to step on your toes.
Well, with that one, because you just made me think of the other one that I never got my hands on.
Okay.
Creepy Crawlers.
Nice.
I never, ever had Creepy Crawlers. And I always wanted, you see the commercial, Creepy Crawlers. And I don't even think I tried to get it. But then I think they came out with one that you could eat after that.
So and is it here? Nope.
Creepy Crawlers, Creepy Crawlers basically is the original 3D printer.
Yes. Is that... Wait, hold on. Okay. Is that the one that went in... I'm thinking of the... not Shrinky Dinks?
Shrinky Dinks, that went in the oven.
That went in the oven.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. But I don't really remember what they were. But when they came out of the oven, they would shrink.
Yeah.
And they were hard plastic.
Yeah. Though. Yep.
Yeah.
But Creepy Crawlers, what were those?
Creepy Crawlers, I believe it came with a little... It was basically the male version of an Easy Bake Oven. You would create these...
They're
once
like
they were done...
molds, right?
They were molds, and they would just come out, and they would be sleep... You know, Creepy Crawlers, basically. They'd be Creepy Crawlers.
Thank you.
They were just soft plastic.
Yep.
And they were like insects, scorpions and stuff like that.
Scorpions.
Never had it, though.
Never had it. Wasn't allowed.
This probably doesn't matter now at this point.
You want me to get you one?
You could, if you go online, you could probably find one.
You probably
get
one.
It's going to be a lot.
All right. My third one is on the order of the Ghostbusters.
Firehouse.
It was Castle Grayskull for He-Man. Mm-hmm. I never had it.
Mm-hmm.
The only one I did have was Battle Action Skeletor. Mm-hmm. That was the one where it hits in the chest and it literally showed damage. Mm-hmm. It rolled in the thing. Mm-hmm. But the one thing I didn't have was Castle Grayskull. And Castle Grayskull was awesome because it opened out And you had, you played in the front, but you also had a party in the back. Am I right?
It was the Barbie Dreamhouse.
It's Barbie Dreamhouse for He-Man. And I'm going to try to see if I can get the commercial for it.
Yeah, you can. But, you definitely can.
Well, or did we just watch it? Anyway, which was interesting on the order of that, and I hope I don't steal it from you, was Skeletor's, was it Mystic Mountain? I think it was. Was his version of Castle Grayskull, but it was Skeletor's lair, or I think it was Mystic Mountain, I want to say. That had ooze in it.
Yeah,
and it was
the ooze.
80s, late 80s, early 90s toys had so much crap.
Extra.
Goop.
Goop. Or, yes.
And just bleh, that would come out, and it was like once that, and I'll never forget, you could play with this once.
Mm-hmm.
But when it's gone and it dries out, we are not replacing it.
It's gone.
We are not. It's gone. Is it gone? And I found myself saying that to my kids that.
Yeah, because you just, what did they want you to do?
What we got?
Put it on like auto order from Amazon.
400 pounds of freaking Play-Doh. Ooze. What are we going to do with this?
Ooze.
Unbelievable. Anyways, So yes, that's my third is Castle Grayskull. Never had it.
Okay, I will go with another out of nowhere thing.
Go.
Super Soakers. Do you remember? So the Super Soakers would come out
The original.
They would have the little one, the 50.
Yes.
So they would have the 50.
Tell me.
That was like the pistol.
Yeah.
You had to still put water in it.
Standard issue
was the 50. Then they had the 150. Then they had one that you needed to wear. You needed to strap it on. No, not the backpack. I think it was a 250.
Yes.
And it had two barrels. It was like, okay, so I think the 50.
It was after Predator and Jesse the Body Ventura had the Gatling gun.
Yeah, but I think the 50 was like a regular half bottle.
Yes.
The 100 was the full bottle. The 250
had the canisters.
I don't even know, but the 250 had two giant ones, and the thing was probably about this big. And you needed to put the strap on it because it was so heavy. I mean, you're talking about, you're talking about 10 pounds of water, probably.
Water. 10 pounds of water.
10 pounds of water. And if you had that thing, not only that thing shot like.
Yeah. Do you remember the
25 feet or something?
Do you remember the grenades? And it was just basically like it was just
a little bit of plastic.
And it was
with the balloon. The water balloon. Yeah.
Water balloon. Dude, that's awesome.
Super Soakers, yeah.
Super Soakers.
Oh. So that would be my third.
That's your third?
Yeah.
All right. Well, I'm gonna keep it strictly toys, and not a weapon.
Mm-hmm. Well, hey, listen, that's what you did.
I play. You know what I did? I played with my Thundercats. I played with my Lion-O. Actually, mm-hmm. I didn't have Lion-O.
Mm-hmm.
I have what's left of
That's
them.
That's too bad.
I have what's left of them.
Oh.
Mumra. He was the villain and not the little decrepit
Lion-O, I'm gonna get you.
He was he was
all, just like him.
And I had the one where it had a ring and it was funny. The ring was just this little rinky-dink piece of plastic that had literally connected to a car battery, it seemed like.
That's
it was
so
a double A, a double A battery. I never forget this. And you actually put it on the back of the guy and his Mumra, and his eyes would light up.
That's so cool.
It was cutting edge. And of course, you bring him in the bathtub with you.
Oh, yeah.
And it would be like shorted out.
Yeah, he's dead.
He's dead.
He gone.
You know he dead.
He's dead.
You need to wipe yourself off.
He's gone.
You're dead. Yeah. Anyway, that's my fourth is Mumra from Thundercats.
The last, my fourth.
The Mohegans.
Which I'll throw in there too.
Super
and
Nintendo.
I only had like one or two of them.
Okay.
Again, BK. He had all the stuff. He had the WWF ring.
Oh, the ring.
He had the ring.
The ultra blue one. The royal blue one.
Yep, the blue one with the ropes.
Yep.
And I had, like I said, one or two of the action figures. He had a ton of them. And unfortunately, they are gone. I asked him for them. He doesn't know where they are. He thinks they are probably thrown out. But I would have. He had everybody.
Everybody in the ring getting tipsy.
Yeah. So I'll throw that in. Also,
that was great.
My parents never loved me enough to get me a Teddy Ruxpin.
Wow.
That was my that's my
honorable mention.
Honorable mention, yeah, Teddy Ruxpin.
God. Well, that's amazing. I mean, Do you have any of these toys left that you just mentioned? Have you seen these recently?
I've seen the wrestling ones.
Okay.
You still almost have them? I tried to get the ones that he had.
Available.
And they're gone.
There's a spot.
Is this gone?
There's a spot up about half hour from here that we should probably do a road show with.
Yeah.
It's called Pandora's Box.
Yeah. Okay? Yeah.
And have you ever been there?
No, but I've
been there a bunch of times.
They had a lot of wrestlers there.
I know the owners there. And they have so much stuff. Mm-hmm. So much stuff. More than meets the eye. Get it? Anyway. Dead air. So that's good.
Did you give your fourth?
I did.
What was the fourth? The Castle
Mumra.
Oh, Mumra.
Mumra. I still have my Mumra. I still have my Mumra.
My Mumra.
I still have my Optimus Prime.
Mm-hmm.
And I still have my Battle Action Skeletor.
I wouldn't have any of those.
What I have that I didn't mention was Daniel-san from Karate Kid. And he had literally, it's like the G.I. Joe Kung Fu grip.
Yeah.
And you hit this switch on the back.
Yeah.
And it was like...
Well, that's the great thing about those toys.
They were so lame. Yeah. And half of them is
so lame, but cutting edge.
Is completely white. As white as this.
Why?
The other half of him is as yellow as that.
Why?
Who knows? Two different factories?
Like that, or?
No, over time.
Oh.
It has not done.
Not aged well?
Not aged well at all. Well. So, yeah. But comment down below. Let us know what your favorite toy was.
Who's on your Rushmore?
Oh. Who's on your Rushmore?
Who's on your Rushmore of toys?
Yep.
BK, don't bother commenting because I already gave them you two. That I wish I had.
Nice.
Yeah. Anyway, so that's it.
That's it.
Thank you, ChatGPT.
Yep. Thank you for nothing. Thank you for this waste of time.
Yep.
And waste of space.
No, I think we got a lot out of it.
I think we pivoted enough from this.
Yeah.
These topics.
Yeah.
And yeah. Well, you better follow us as in this presidential season.
Yeah, we're coming up on a We haven't even made our opening debate yet.
We just
created this.
We may take. We may have to go and release shorts on our own reconnaissance to try to get
that would be a good idea.
Our own following.
That would be
so.
Good
be
idea.
On the lookout for some.
We need
random...
logos.
You need a logo.
No, I need you to make me a logo.
I can be bought. But anyway, no. But seriously, leave a like, subscribe, comment down below what your favorite part of this video was, and we'll see you on the next one.
Real quick though,
go
check out this video.
Oh yeah.
If you like this, if you stuck around this long, check out this video.
Yep.
We just did this. Everything 90s.
Everything 90s. It's awesome.
It's right here.
He's Matt.
Yeah, that's John. See and we're out of nowhere.
See you on the next one.
And out of time.